we shall reflect on the life of Saint Magdalene of Canossa. Saint Magdalene of Canossa, foundress of the Canossian family of the Sons and Daughters of Charity, was born at Verona on the 2nd of March 1774. Her father, a wealthy marquis, having died when she was barely 5, and her mother having remarried soon after, the young girl was brought up by an uncle and given a good education. In 1799, Magdalene started her work for poor girls, and the following year began to provide some of them with accommodation. In the year 1803, she opened her first school and wanted to live there, but returned home in deference to her family's wishes. In 1808, she founded her religious congregation for the educational and healthcare apostolate. At the time of her death, on the 10th of April 1835, there were 5 houses of Canossian sisters. Today the congregation has almost 4,000 members in 395 houses in many countries. Magdalene was beatified by Pope Pius XII on the 7th of December 1941, and the miracle required for canonization was officially recognized on the 11th of December 1987. She was canonized by Pope John Paul II on the 2nd of October 1988. The heartbeat of Magdalene's apostolic choice vibrates through the institution that she founded and which she wished to be dedicated and consecrated to charity. She lived during the Napoleonic times of revolutions, invasions, and restorations, which left a trail of evil behind them. She wished to provide for all these. The hallmark of her personal charisma was her ability to distinguish Christian charity from philanthropy. The cultural changes of today have brought in their own wake crops of evils. Saint Magdalene meets these challenges today through her sons and daughters of charity. With her as their model of being all things to all men, the Canossians run schools for all age groups, as well as special schools for the blind, the handicapped, and the slow learners, for those of the silent world, as well as training centers for nurses and daycare schools for others. All these flourish, and through them, all the Canossians make God known so that He may be loved. In the villages, they worked for the social upliftment through informal education and Mahila Mandals, dispensaries, mother-child projects, preventive health care, and leper clinics. They also dedicate themselves generously in parishes and Sunday schools, as well as serving the poor, the youth, and the marginalized. Realizing today the objectives that Saint Magdalene had long foreseen for them.